Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilpendi. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture series on the subject heat and mass transfer. So we are discussing on radiation heat transfer, and today the lecture is number 14, and the topic for the today's discussion is gas radiation. So we discussed various radiation heat transfer concepts, radiation between black surfaces, radiation between two gray surfaces, radiation between three surface enclosure. In all the discussions, we assume that there is no medium in between the two surfaces or the surface which exchange heat by radiation. So what we discussed earlier, it is only heat transfer between the surfaces, and we neglected the fluid medium in the between the two surfaces. But normally in the atmosphere, when there is radiation heat transfer, the atmospheric air is available, and the radiation heat transfer occurs in the presence of the atmospheric air, but we ignore the effect of the atmospheric air in the radiation heat transfer process. But in practice, the gases in the atmospheric air, the CO, I mean the oxygen and the nitrogen, they are also participating in the radiation heat transfer process, but we ignore. Now we are going to discuss the gas radiation, the radiation heat transfer in the case of a combustion chamber of IC engine, combustion chamber of a boiler, combustion chamber of a gas turbine power plant. So wherever there is combustion is taking place, there is heat transfer between the gases, the hot flame or the hot gases and the metal surface. In all the boiler or the gas turbine, there is heat transfer between the hot gases and the metal surface. Now we are going to discuss this topic, gas radiation. So the radiation between hot gases and the metal surface. So we recap. So in the earlier lecture, we discussed the three surface, but heat radiation between three surface enclosure, and we assumed one surface is re-radiating. But here we are going to discuss the gas radiation. So the learning outcome for this lecture. So at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to define what is the mean beam length, and he will be able to explain the radiation calculation. So various methodology to calculate the various equations to calculate the radiation heat transfer between the gas and the metal surface. So in the gas radiation problem, what are all the given data, what are all the information should be available prior to the solving the problem, prior to understand the problem? The total volume of the gas enclosure, it depends on the shape of the combustion chamber, maybe cylindrical, rectangular, or any shape, hemispherical like that. And from the volume, when you have a combustion chamber, there are some heat surface, heat transfer surface. So total surface area of the gas enclosure, and gas temperature, wall temperature, and in the combustion, when there is burning in the gas, burning of any fuel, hydrocarbon fuel, the main two constituents, gas constituents, are CO2 and H2O. There are many more gas constituents, but we consider only these two are the major gas constituents in the hot gases of the combustion chamber. And we should know the partial pressure of the gas constituents, that is partial pressure of CO2 and partial pressure of water vapor, and total pressure of the combustion chamber, and that is also like a total pressure of the gas enclosure. So these are all the information required to solve the problem in gas radiation. First step, we have to calculate the mean beam length. L is defined as 3.6 into V by A, that is V is the volume of the gas enclosure, total volume of the gas enclosure, and A is the total surface area of the enclosure. So 3.6 into V by A, that is the first we have to calculate. Then emissivity of CO2. We have to calculate emissivity of CO2 and using this graph. So this graph is on the page number 106 on your heat and mass transfer data book. And this emissivity of CO2 is a function of gas temperature and partial pressure of CO2, the product of partial pressure of CO2 into mean beam length. There are two parameters. One is the gas temperature and another parameter is PCO2 into L. So we have to calculate PCO2 into L. L is the beam length which we calculated earlier. In the first step, we calculate the beam length and we have to multiply with the PCO2, which is partial pressure of CO2. So look at the graph. The x-axis is the temperature in Kelvin, that is gas temperature in Kelvin, and the y-axis is the epsilon CO2, that is emissivity of CO2, and the lines for different values of PCO2 into L. So you find PCO2 into L, knowing the temperature, and you can find out what is epsilon CO2, emissivity of the carbon dioxide. And we have to calculate the correction factor for epsilon CO2. So the correction factor is also is a function of total pressure and PCO2 and L. This graph is available on the page number 107. And look at the x-axis. It is the total pressure of the combustion chamber. And the lines are for the product of PCO2 into L. So knowing the PCO2 into L and total pressure, we can calculate the correction factor for CO2. So CCO2 is a function of total pressure and PCO2 into L. Then emissivity of H2O. So this is the graph to calculate the, to find the emissivity of H2O. And this is on the page number 108 on your heat and mass transfer data book. And the x-axis, so this is again epsilon H2O is the function of Tg and the product of PH2O into L. So partial pressure of water vapor into beam length, mean beam length. And look at the graph. X-axis we have the temperature and the lines for constant values of PH2O into L and the y-axis is epsilon H2O. So knowing these two values, you can find out what is epsilon H2O. So this is the emissivity of H2O. And the correction factor for H2O, CH2O is a function of PH2O and the PH2O plus PT divided by 2. So this graph is available on the page number 109. X-axis is PH2O plus PT divided by 2 in atmospheric pressure and the PH2O into L, which is in atmospheric meter. So all the pressure only in terms of atmospheric pressure. And you have to take the correction factor from the graph, page number 109. And take the emissivity correction factor, delta epsilon for mutual absorption of H2O and CO2 in present in the mixer. So the CO2 is emitting, H2O is also emitting, and the energy emitted by CO2 is absorbed by the H2O, energy emitted by H2O is emitted by H2O is absorbed by the CO2. So for mutual absorption, we have to find out the delta epsilon from this graph, which is on page number 110 in your heat and mass transfer data book. And look at the value. So the x-axis is PH2O divided by PCO2 plus PH2O, and the three graphs for the different temperature, 400 Kelvin, 811 Kelvin and 1200 Kelvin. If the gas temperature is other than the three values, either you have to go for interpolation or extrapolation to find the value of the delta epsilon. So delta epsilon is on the y-axis. So you have to take the value of delta epsilon. So knowing all the values from the five different graphs, now you have to calculate the emissivity of the CO2 and H2O, which is epsilon G equal to epsilon CO2 plus CCO2 plus epsilon H2O plus CH2O minus delta epsilon. So epsilon CO2 is the emissivity of CO2 carbon dioxide and correction factor of the carbon dioxide plus C epsilon H2O is the emissivity of H2O and CH2O is the correction factor of the H2O minus delta epsilon is the correction factor for mutual absorption. And then you have to calculate the absorbability of the gaseous mixture. And this equation alpha G equal to alpha CO2 CCO2 plus alpha H2O, CH2O minus delta alpha. Now we have the graph only to calculate, only to find the emissivity of the various gases, particularly the CO2 and H2O. To calculate the absorbability, we have to use the same graph. We have to use the same graph. So the value of alpha CO2 equal to epsilon dash CO2 Tg by Tw to the power 0.65 into C dash CO2, and alpha H2O equal to epsilon dash H2O into Tg by Tw to the power 0.45 into C dash H2O, delta alpha equal to delta epsilon. So here epsilon dash CO2, epsilon dash H2O, C dash CO2, C dash H2O, and delta epsilon dash, all the values are evaluated from the same graph using the value Tw. Earlier we have taken the gas temperature, now we have to take the wall temperature to calculate the values. And in addition to that, earlier we calculated with respect to PCO2 into L, now we have to calculate PCO2 into L into Tw by Tg, and similarly PH2O into L into Tw by Tg, and strictly the temperature are in Kelvin. So Tw and Tg value should be in Kelvin. So using the same graph, for these parameters, we have to calculate alpha G, absorbability of the gaseous mixture constituting CO2 and H2O. Now the net heat transfer between the gas and the enclosure, heat flux Q by small q equal to capital Q by A equal to sigma into epsilon G Tg to the power 4 minus alpha G Tw to the power 4. This is what the heat transfer, heat exchange by between the gas and the enclosure by means of radiation. So you just go through the video, take the notes, note down the graph available in the heat and mass transfer data book. Once we solve your problem, you can understand the how to use the heat and mass transfer data book to solve the gas radiation problem. And these are all the books I referred for the discussion. So you can also reach to the book to have further knowledge on the subject. And this is the book what I have published earlier on this subject. You can read it for better clarity of the subject. And if you have any queries, you can write to me to my mail ID. I will sincerely answer all your queries. Thank you. We'll meet again.